Hey everyone, welcome back to A to B. Today we're just talking about the weight of Nespresso capsules and how much coffee you actually get in them, because a recent viewer left a comment asking how much coffee do you get out of one of these capsules. And the reason he wanted to know is because he wanted to know, when you go to like Starbucks or to Costa, if you're going to get, when they say, oh, you get a venti coffee and they add 3 shots to it, how does that relate to an espresso pod? Do you get 2 shots out of a pod, or do you get 1 shot or 3 shots? So we're just sort of answer that question. And also, I thought, if you've come to this video through search and you're thinking how much coffee's in it, you might also want to know literally the weight, how many grams of coffee come in a capsule, because you might be comparing it to, say, like a bag of filter coffee and how much you're using a scoop of that. Or the other reason I thought you might be interested in is you might want to know the caffeine content. So we'll just talk a little bit about that now. The first one, how many shots of coffee do you get out of an espresso pod? Well, your average espresso pod, say this one here, that will give you 1 espresso shot. Some people try to run them through twice, but I wouldn't recommend it. It tends to end up making your coffee taste not very nice. So that will give you like 1 espresso shot. And so if you went to Starbucks and you were getting a venti coffee and it had 3 shots in it, you're going to need 3 of these capsules. That's on the original machine. On the virtual machine, they do have a double espresso capsule, so that's the only exception to that. But in general, it's 1 per capsule. However, if you're liking a long, if you have a stretched out coffee, and that's the type that you like and prefer, then they do a longo capsule as well. So which one's a lungo? I think it's this one. That's an in vivo lungo. And that gives you a 110ml coffee instead of a 40ml coffee. But that's not the kind where you would get a shot from Starbucks. That's a different type of coffee completely. So 1 shot equals 1 pod as a rule with the original line machines. I'll just grab some virtual pods now. And we'll just pop them on top, just to show you the difference. So this is the double espresso pod, but on the virtual they also do like mug size coffees, and so that gives you a full mug of coffee, a 230ml coffee out of 1 pod. But they're more expensive because, as you can see, even on that there's more coffee in them. So these mug size coffees are more expensive than like a double espresso or a single espresso one on the virtual. And they're definitely more expensive than just the single ones on the original machine. So I hope that's answered the first part of the question of how much coffee you get in relation to how many shots per pod. So let's go to the second part of the question, and we'll think about how many grams of coffee are actually in it. In one of these little original pods here, if it's an espresso-sized pod, you get about 5 grams of coffee. If it's a lungo pod, it's more like 6 grams of coffee. You might think that doesn't relate to the difference in size of cups. You might think that it should be at least double the size or triple the size even for a lungo. Well, that's not the case, because it's more to do with how the type of coffee that's in the pod, which allows it to brew a 110ml coffee with just a small pod still. So don't worry about that. Okay, so let's have a quick chat about the caffeine content in these capsules then. So on the original range, the caffeine content goes from around 40 grams of caffeine per capsule to up to 130. And on the Vertuo, it's about 60 to 100 milligrams of caffeine per capsule. I actually went online and asked Nespresso a question about this, because I wanted to know the individual ones for, say, each capsule, like how much was in a ristretto or how much was in a Kazar. But they couldn't give me an answer for some reason. I don't know why, but they gave me the range. But I did read online somewhere, don't quote me on this, it's probably the Kazar that has the most caffeine in it. Just in case you're after one, a high caffeine capsule. But it's just something I read online, so it could be true, it could not. So how does that actually relate in real terms to, say, a normal cup of instant coffee? Well, they're saying that an average 5 gram Nespresso capsule coffee will contain around 65 milligrams of caffeine. So how does that compare to other things? Well, a cup of filter coffee, this is from the Nespresso website, an average cup of filter coffee will contain around 75 milligrams of caffeine, a mug of instant coffee around 100 milligrams of caffeine, a cup of tea around 50 milligrams, a can of Coke or a standard Coke drink 40 milligrams, and a standard energy drink about 80 milligrams of caffeine, and a dark chocolate bar, surprisingly, up to 50 milligrams of caffeine. So that kind of shows you how much caffeine is in each of these capsules. So that I just thought I added that into the video because I thought that might be something that you want to know, and that's maybe you were thinking coffee and you're meaning caffeine. So that's hopefully we've covered the three areas there where you could end up wanting to know how much coffee is in an espresso pod. So what I'll do now quickly, I'll just make one for you so you can see the espresso shot coming through. So like we said, one of these capsules will make one espresso sized coffee. I'm due a coffee, so I'll quickly make one now. And I'll go with, this is from the new Italiano range, the Inspirazione. But I'll just run one through and you can see how big they are. So there we have it, one espresso shot for one pod or capsule. So just to quickly recap, 5 milligrams of coffee per pod, one shot per pod on average for an espresso shot. They do a lungo capsule, Vertuo, they also do a double espresso capsule. Hope that all that information has helped you out. Please feel free to subscribe to the channel. Please give it a like if it's helped you, and you'll get more tips in future going forward about Nespresso. Check out our playlist, which I'll link to in a minute. It's got loads of Nespresso tips on there. Thanks for watching this video, and bye for now.